Today we are here to perform an experiment to draw the various characteristics of the centrifugal pump. In this we will basically study the effect of speed on the efficiency of the pump. For this we are having a centrifugal pump test rig. Okay, so now I will take you to this centrifugal pump test rig to show you the various components of this test rig, and then after doing it we will come back again to this observation table and we will see how the efficiency of the turbine varies with the speed. Student, this is our centrifugal pump test rig. Now looking into the various component of this centrifugal pump test rig, first of all comes this energy meter. Okay, this energy meter basically we will be using to measure the energy input to this centrifugal pump test rig. We will note down the pulse. Okay, this energy meter blinks. You must have seen the energy meter at your home. It blinks. So we will note down the pulse that are coming in 10 seconds, and from that we will calculate the energy input to this centrifugal pump test rig. Now next component is this electrical motor. Then comes the centrifugal pump. This electrical motor and centrifugal pump, they are coupled, okay, together with the help of this belt pulley arrangement. Okay, you can see this is a belt pulley cover. Okay, belt pulley cover, and in that there is a belt and a pulley. So this belt pulley arrangement couples your pump and your motor. Now then this measuring tank, with the help of this measuring tank we will be basically measuring the flow rate that is taking place inside this centrifugal test rig. Now what will happen, okay, this is the storage tank here also, and this storage tank will store the water, and the water will be sucked by the centrifugal pump, and from this delivery pump it will enter into this measuring tank, and from this measuring tank with the help of this valve it will come back to this tank, that is the reservoir of this centrifugal pump test rig. Now what are the things we will be measuring? We will be measuring the pulse. Okay, as I told you, we will be measuring the pulse that is coming in 10 seconds. Then we will measure this suction pressure, okay, and this delivery pressure. This sum of the suction pressure and delivery pressure, okay, will give you the manometric head. Okay, and we will be measuring this, the flow rate, with the help of this measuring tank. Now this energy input will be given by this energy meter. Energy output we will be calculating from here with the help of this manometer, with the flow rate, and multiplying that by the specific gravity of the water will give you the energy output. So energy output divided by energy input will give you the efficiency of this centrifugal pump test rig. Now as I have told you, we have to draw and we have to study the variation of the efficiency of this test rig with respect to speed. So for varying the speed, this belt pulley arrangement is so made that one of the pulley of this belt pulley is very much speed pulley. So that will help us to vary the speed of this centrifugal pump. If the speed of the centrifugal pump will vary, of course the pressure and the flow rate will vary, and that will vary the energy output. So correspondingly the energy input will also vary. So with the help of that we can study the variation of your overall efficiency of this pump with respect to speed. Now for you, I am taking down the readings, noting it, and then we will move to the observation table on the blackboard, and we will discuss the various observations that are made by me. Students, I have taken observation for you, and now I will show you what I have got. First of all, discussing about what is given data. Okay, what are the given values to us? First value is energy meter constant. We its value is given to be 3200 pulse per kilowatt hour, then area of the main tank is given to be 0.128 liters here. Then the density of the water is given to be 1000 kg per meter cube. Then this water efficiency, the water that is a part of the test rig, its efficiency is given to be 0.8 meter. Then height of the pressure gauge above the vacuum gauge, that means the difference between the height of the pressure gauge and the vacuum gauge, it is given to be 1 meter. Now this is the observation table and these are the observed values that I have taken for you. Now this is the screen. Okay. The variation in the speed that we can make with the help of variable speed pulley. Now, once we can get 2050, then 2450, and this is the full speed, which is the speed of the motor also, that is 2800. So, corresponding to each speed, we have noted down the drilling pressure and suction pressure. Now, you can see that this is the drilling pressure and this is the suction pressure. Now, coming to the observation in case of mirroring tank, these are the values R1 and R2. R1 is the final value and R2 is the initial value, and the corresponding change is the time taken to change from R2 to R1. Okay, from R2 to R1, the change in reading will come in T seconds. That means the water level, that is 23.5, is changing to 28.5 in 7 seconds. Okay. Now next is the readings corresponding to the energy meter. Okay. So these are the pulse values we have. In each case we have intentionally taken the value to be 10 and corresponding time for 10 pulse. Now you know as the blinking increases, the time reduces. Okay, so you can say more is the energy, more will be the blinking. So that will help you. You can see here the speed is less, so time taken for 10 pulse is more as compared to when the speed is high. You can compare these things. So these are the values we have got from the energy meter. Now coming to the formula used. First of all, the formula is for the input energy, which is given by P upon TP into 3600. This is the formula that is given by the motor manufacturer, and from this we can get the energy input. Now we know since our motor is not 100% efficient, it is only 80% efficient, so it will transmit only 80% of the power. So energy on the shaft of the pump will be given by EI into efficiency of the motor, which is 0.8. From here you will get the energy that is available on the shaft of the pump. Then energy output by the pump, that is energy given by the pump, will be given by rho g tau h upon 1000 in kilowatt. So you can get all these values from this observation table, and by using this observation table corresponding to each reading 1, 2, 3, you will get your EI, ES and E0. Okay, so by using this we will calculate all these parameters. Now after calculating EI, ES and E0, you will be calculating two efficiencies. One is the overall efficiency of this centrifugal pump test rig, and second is the efficiency of the pump. Overall efficiency of this test rig is given by E0 divided by EI, that is energy output upon energy input. Okay, into 100. Then pump efficiency will be given by E0 upon ES, that is energy output upon energy input to the pump, multiplied by 100. So by this we will get overall efficiency and efficiency of the pump corresponding to each speed. So with the help of this data, you can predict and you can study how the efficiency of the pump and the centrifugal test rig varies with this speed. Thank you.